Hey guys, Nick here. Today we'll be taking a look at another one of the bosses that has been up for testing on the beta realm, Garalon. Garalon is a single phase fight and has attackable legs that play a big part in the way that you execute the encounter. As always, I shouldn't have to remind you, but by now this is a very early look at the boss, and really the only thing that should be taken away from this video is how the main mechanic works, and using this playthrough to help you kill the boss. Let's overview the encounter. So as mentioned before, Garalon has attackable legs, and they play a big part in how the fight plays out. Now you need to be able to keep them dead in order to be able to kite him at a slow enough speed to not have him catch up and melee the person kiting him. Not much to the fight, so we'll start by looking at the mechanics, and then go over the tactics that we use to kill it. So we'll start with the easiest. Furious Swipes is an ability that forces at least two tanks to take every hit every time he casts it. It's a frontal cone and does an earthquake effect on the floor when cast. Now, if two tanks fail to get hit by the ability, he'll gain Fury, increasing his damage dealt and his movement speed for 30 seconds. Next is the Crush ability, where he will inflict 150,000 damage to all players and an additional 800,000 if they are under him when cast. Garalon only casts this ability when a player is detected underneath him, which is nicely marked by the purple dotted line, or when a pass of the pheromones debuff happens. Which brings me nicely onto the main mechanic, pheromones. Now this is a debuff placed on the initial person who pulls and can be traded to another person simply by walking over each other. Pheromones forces Garalon to fixate on that person, as well as doing a stacking debuff that inflicts 15,000 damage every 2 seconds, increasing in stack every 2 seconds as well. What the tooltip misses off is that the damage at the moment seems to be inflicted to everybody in the raid, not only the person carrying the debuff. On top of all that, they leave behind a trail on the floor which inflicts 100,000 damage to players within 4 yards, and damages if you run through it. Tied to all this is Garalon himself and his legs. Now they are all separate mobs, including him, with each leg having a weak point ring around it, meaning that if you stand inside of the circle and attack one of the legs, you will do 100% more damage to that leg. Garalon is slowed by 15% and damaged for 3% of his total HP for every leg that is broken and killed. This effect can stack and must be. Garalon can also repair one of his legs every few seconds back to full HP and thus loses a stack of the buff, Broken Leg. Now, the way in which we tackled this fight was to have our main tank initially pick him up, taking the pheromones debuff and allowing all the DPS to dot and damage the legs as much as possible. After a few seconds, one of our ranged DPS would take the debuff off of the tank and start running around the room. The trick to kiting, as always, is to let the boss come as close to you as possible before sprinting over the other side of the room, then following a square pattern around the room as best as possible. You should never have more than 20 or so stacks before swapping to another ranged. We actually found that we needed 3 ranged DPS to take the debuff in order for a rotation to form. Simply be able to kite him, keep the legs all dead, and make sure the tanks take every ability that they need to, with no one going under the boss. This fight is going to be all about getting those in place. Tanks, kiting, range DPS, legs down. I expect to see some complex stuff having to be done to push this over at come heroic. As always, I hope you ended up taking something away from this video. Thanks very much for watching, guys.